it all started ages ago, in 1882. In that year, all Berlin was crazy about roller skating. It swept the city. When the skating craze died down, the rink became, well, our first home. Good old Philharmonic Hall. Ludwig von Breuner was our first conductor. And on October 17, 1882, we had our first tremendous success. As a matter of fact, in the beginning, we were a very popular orchestra, if you know what I mean. Very popular, what you'd call pops nowadays. The audience sat at tables. The old man had a beer. Frankfurters could be had. Mother attended to her knitting. But daughter had a chance to look over all the eligible young men, or the other way around. Engagement concerts, people called them, and after a while, the one-time skating rink offered a complete symphony, which was an event. No more Frankfurters from then on. Tables vanished from the hall, and people sat in rows of high-backed chairs, as if they were in church, some of them muttered. Hans von Bülow led the orchestra about that time. He of the short concerts and the long rehearsals. He made us into a real orchestra, a magnificent instrument of its own kind. Berlin achieved a musical reputation. And then came Arthur Nikisch. When Arthur Nikisch conducted Wagner, Tchaikovsky, Beethoven, people forgot all about their humdrum lives. To listen to Beethoven under Nikisch, you thought you heard the seas roar and the mountains dream. The soloists we had, Sarasate, Paderewski, Pablo Casals, Edwin Fischer. Lehman sang, and Fyodor Shalyapin. Once were the glory of music. After Nikisch's death in 1917, the orchestra chose a young man to lead it on, Wilhelm Furtwängler. But there was almost no conductor of name or renown who did not conduct us time and again. Listen.